Hello and welcome to the 6th devlog. The first thing you may notice is that I implemented a dynamic rush. For now it's nothing great, but it already makes the whole environment more alive and appealing to look at. It will need a lot of testing to understand how much and how I can use it. So let's move on to the main topic of the video, the skill system. I decided to delete and rethink the level system, as it didn't fit much with the style and atmosphere of the game. Now there are four main skills: fitness, style, shooting and charisma. This skill can be leveled up by playing the game normally. For example, shooting increases when dealing damage and fitness when walking or running. As you can see from their name, these skills will increase the character's abilities, creating a more gradual progression. This is where the first problem begins. There isn't a noticeable difference when leveling up, and there is a risk of making the player feel that leveling up is useless. Because, for example, increasing fitness provides a small bonus to stamina that is almost unnoticeable. So I thought that once the player has reached a center level with the skill, he can choose to specialize in different fields, choosing his own playstyle. Here are some examples. The fitness skill specializes in jogger, mule and sprinter. So jogger provides a substantial increase in stamina, and you can run freely if you're under a certain threshold of weight carried. Suitable for those who like action because it allows you to move quickly around the map. Mule increases the maximum transportable weight and allows you to move even if you're overweight, so suitable for those who don't want to leave anything behind. Sprinter increases the run speed and decreases the consumed stamina. Useful for escaping from the most dangerous situation and repositioning yourself in the battlefield. So, move on, for example, to the style skill and specialization. These are Loot Goblin, Stealth and Scouting. The first one, Loot Goblin, greatly increases the speed of looting and increases the amount of items that are found in chests. Stealth increases the time before enemy can spot you and increases the damage if you're not detected. Scouting lets you spot enemies before they enter your field of vision and takes longer to track loose of them. It also increases the amount of hidden chests in the maps. These are just some few examples, and the skills are obviously not definitive, but I think specializing the basic skill is a good thing to diversify the playstyle. In addition to the main skill tree, there are other four skills: medicine, gunsmith, cooking, and craftsmanship. This skill can be unlocked and increased by finding the corresponding book. You might be wondering, how come they are not increased by performing the corresponding action? If I cook a lot, it will also increase my cooking skill, right? Yes, but there is a big problem. The grinding. We all played Skyrim, no? Spending hours crafting iron daggers just to increase my thing is not fun. So for now, the player has to explore and complete quests to get these books. Because my idea is to make crafting as important as trading is. So, for example, sellers will not have unlimited money, and you cannot sell everything you loot. This forced the player to decide what to keep and what to discard during the game. If not, the big gameplay becomes: I enter a map, I collect everything, and then I sell it, and with the money, I buy what I need. I don't want it to be that. I want that the player has to decide what to loot based on his current needs. I would also like to tell you about another thought I had. The game is based on looting, so there are many items that can be looted but have no purpose. So how to make this item usable for something? In the bunker there are slots where the player can build modules that will give you bonuses. So, the material needed are therefore all the useless items found in the maps. While it's up to the player to decide which modules to build according to his choice, obviously not all modules can be built at the same time. Some examples of modules are: the bedroom, which allows you to heal wounds and fatigue faster, while also providing a bonus for all experience gained. Kitchen allows you to cook your own meals without having to spend money to acquire ready-made food. Another example is the gym that increases the stamina and experience gained from the fitness skill. Move on, for example, to storage that increase the player's chest so he can store more items, and the workshop that allows the player to repair weapon and armor by himself. Some modules require a certain level in the corresponding skill to be built, so for example, if you want to build a kitchen, you have to at least 1 point in cooking. I also changed the way the player leaves the map. Previously, you had to wait for the train to arrive, but the location was obviously on the rail, the same ones where the player was left at the beginning. This limited exploration, because, for example, the player starts at point A, goes to point B to loot, and returns to point A to exit. Now the exit points are randomly chosen at the edge of the map, so it becomes A to B, and to exit you must go to C. This increases the distance and therefore the danger for the player, making each successful exit more satisfying. Before finish, I would like to say you that I will be busy in the near future and I will not be able to work much on the project. So thank you all and see you in the next video. Bye.